Gentlemen, good day and welcome to Suraj Estate Developers Limited Q4 FY24 earnings conference call. This conference call may contain forward-looking statements about the company which are based on beliefs, opinions and expectations of the company as on the date of this call. These statements are not the guarantees of future performance and involve risks and uncertainties that are difficult to predict. As a reminder, all participant lines will be in the listen-only mode, and there will be an opportunity for you to ask questions after the presentation concludes. Should you need assistance during the conference call, please signal an operator by pressing star, then zero on your touchtone phone. Please note that this conference is being recorded. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Rahul Thomas, whole-time director. Thank you, and over to you, sir.
Good morning, and I welcome everyone to our Q4 FY24 earnings conference call. Along with me, we have our CFO, Mr. Shripal Shah, and SGA, our investor relation advisors. I hope all of you have gone through our investor presentation uploaded on the exchange and our company website. Since this is our maiden call, I would like to give a brief overview of our company and the industry, followed by a review of the financial performance of the company during the quarter and the year ended March 24. Suraj Estate has been actively involved in the real estate business since 1986, specializing in the development of real estate across the residential and commercial sectors in South Central Mumbai region. The residential portfolio is strategically located in the markets of Mahim, Dadar, Prabhadevi and Parel, which are sub-markets of South Central Mumbai, where we have established a significant presence. We are now expanding our footprint into the residential real estate development in the Bandra sub-market. Our focus lies on value luxury, which is 1 and 2 BHK compact homes in prime locations of the city. The second being the luxury segment, which caters to the clientele up to 2, 3, 4 BHKs, including duplex and penthouses, and the commercial segment, which is built to suit commercial offices. Our expertise lies in the redevelopment of tenanted properties under DCR 33-7 and society redevelopment under 33-7B of the DCPR 2034. Given that most land parcels in South Central Mumbai market are redevelopment projects, the core competence of our company lies in tenant settlement, a crucial element for unlocking value on such land parcels. The company identifies cessed or non-cessed properties with existing tenants, ties up with the landlords of such tenanted properties by entering into a development agreement or an outright purchase through a conveyance deed. Since incorporation, we have successfully completed 42 projects with a developed area of more than 10 lakh square feet in South Central Mumbai region. We have also developed custom spaces for leading institutions including National Stock Exchange of India, ICICI Bank, Saraswat Bank, Union Bank of India and Clearing Corporation of India Limited. In addition to the completed projects, there are currently 13 ongoing projects with a developable area of more than 20 lakh square feet and a saleable RERA carpet of more than 6 lakh square feet, corresponding to a sold and unsold value of 1350 crores in the ongoing portfolio. Furthermore, there are 18 upcoming projects pipeline already acquired by the company, approximately of a carpet area of 9 lakh square feet. To discuss further on the market opportunity, talking about the MMR region, it stands as the India's second largest real estate market. From 2018 to 2023, absorption in the MMR surged at the rate of 14% annually, propelled by several factors, such as rise in disposable incomes and household savings, a growing preference for higher quality residences and larger living spaces, a reverse migration trend triggered by the lifting of COVID-related restrictions and the return to office mandate, along with the urbanization. This heightened absorption stimulated a healthy return increase of 15.2% in the supply during the same period. As of December 23, inventory levels dropped to 13 months low from 30 months in December 2018, primarily due to the robust absorption rates in the recent quarters. Concurrently, pricing experienced a 5.2 compounded annual growth rate over the mentioned period, attributed to a shift towards superior quality, branded offerings, and a diminished inventory levels. Talking about the quarter and the year that went by, the residential real estate market in India soared in Q1 of calendar year 2024, fueled by persistent high demand. High-end and luxury segment led the charge, while the mid-range maintained its dominance in launches. With the infrastructure boom, improved connectivity, and a notable 18% year-on-year absorption rate increase, there's a 31% year-on-year drop in unsold inventory, presenting a growth opportunity for industry players like us. We anticipate that the demand growth in the MMR region will persist. The projection is based on factors such as enhanced affordability, potential reversals in interest rate hikes, a rise in double income household led by young working professionals, and an ongoing improvement in infrastructure. To dwell a bit on the South Central Mumbai market, in the areas of Mahi, Matunga, Dadar, Prabhadevi and Parel, the micro markets we enjoy, 8% share in all redevelopments in this South Central Mumbai market. SEM stands out as one of the robust markets within the MMR region, owing to various factors. Firstly, the area boasts of significant presence of high-income individuals and affluent customer base. Secondly, it is known for its premium and super-premium positioning in the real estate sector. Thirdly, the trend of nuclear families is prevalent, further contributing to its appeal. Lastly, it serves as a prime micro-market for families seeking to upgrade their residential accommodations. Even amidst the recent launches of new projects in the SEM market, we have successfully moved our inventory by leveraging our extensive range of offerings across various budget segments, coupled with our adaptness in pinpointing the ideal product market alignment. A notable characteristic of the SEM market is the limited availability of vacant land parcels. Therefore, any developer seeking to enhance its footprint in the SEM must opt for redevelopment. This is precisely our area of expertise. Drawing upon our extensive experience in redevelopment, we have honed the knowledge and adopted the best practices necessary to revitalize standalone buildings efficiently and cost-effectively. This proficiency has propelled us to leadership positions within this micro market. We are focused largely on identifying properties under DCR 33-7, which offers multiple benefits such as FSI 3 on us getting the MHADA NOC, without any TDR or additional costs, relatively lower approval cost, and typical discount of approximately 30% on the land cost. Unlocking value through our tenant settlement, which has been our expertise. Effective tenant settlement stands as a pivotal aspect of our redevelopment endeavors. With a proven track record, out of 42 projects we've undertaken, we rehoused more than 1,111 tenants free of cost and reconstructing their residences without any financial burden. Although the minimum threshold for tenant approval and consent stands at 51%, our brand reputation, commitment to quality development and punctual delivery have consistently garnered near-unanimous support, securing near 200% approvals for most of our projects. There are more than 19,000 test properties in the island city of Mumbai, which are 50 years old and above, and out of which 16,000 of these buildings are in urgent need of redevelopment, indicating a huge untapped potential. Further, there's a huge scope of society redevelopment under DCR 33-7B, which also falls under our expertise. A few material updates for the quarter. During the quarter under review, we have successfully reached an amicable resolution in a pending litigation with OLV and OLPS Society, which represents a significant positive outcome for us. As per the agreed terms, we have commitment to a payment of approximately 47 crores to the landowner, along with the provision of additional flats measuring 35,500 square feet to the OLV and OLPS Society. This settlement leaves us with a built-up area of more than 10,800 meters, including fungible FSI for sale, equating to a GDV of 350 crores. Additionally, we have secured development rights of a land component spanning over 4,790 meters, including five existing buildings, which comprises of rehousing of 108 tenants stroke occupants. The estimated FSI required for rehousing these occupants is 6,680 meters, leaving us with a balanced built-up area for sale of at least 6,460 meters with a GDV of approximately 225 after surplus areas handed over to MHADA. This favorable resolution represents a significant milestone for our company, reaffirming our commitment to excellence in the real estate sector and providing us with a sales potential of 350 crores. In line with our business expansion strategy, we have also acquired a freehold land at measuring 1,073 square meters off LJ Road, Mahim West, Mumbai. This redevelopment project involves 7 tenant-stroke occupants who have vacated their premises, rendering the plot vacant. After accounting for the FSI required for rehabilitating these tenant-stroke occupants and the surplus area to be handed over to MADA, the estimated balance carpet area is approximately 30,000 square feet with a GDV of 120 crores. During the year under review, we have successfully launched new value luxury stroke luxury project called Lumina, Suraj Lumina at Visavakar Road, Mahim West. The said project lies under Regulation 33.7 of the DCPR. The project comprises of 35 units, including both 2 BHK with a carpet area ranging from 575 to 622 and 3 BHKs with a carpet area of 882 square feet, with a total carpet area of 22,376. The GDV estimate from this project is close to 100 crores. The project is expected to be completed by December 28. Just to give you a perspective of our ongoing projects, out of the 6 lakh square feet, we have already sold 4.89 lakh square feet and have collected 1,171 crores with a balance receivable of 719 crores to be collected. The unsold inventory of 1.21 lakh square feet from the ongoing projects have an estimated GDV of approximately 631 crores. The sold and unsold receivables totaling to 1350 from the ongoing is expected to flow from FY25 to FY29. We have 18 upcoming projects with an estimated carpet area of more than 9 lakh square feet. 67% of this comprises of value luxury projects. 21% belongs to the value luxury and the luxury projects, and the balance 12% is the commercial segment for sale. The estimated carpet area for sale from these upcoming projects is estimated at 9 lakh square feet. We estimate a price of 50 to 55,000 per square foot on this portfolio. We plan to launch 7 new projects with a carpet area of 2.66 lakh square feet with a total GDV of 1,150 crores for the financial year 24-25. Our focus continues in enhancing our market position in South Central Mumbai, pursuing our differential product offerings in our value luxury segment, expanding our land reserves in the SCM and other MMR regions, selectively developing commercial projects in the SCM region, redeveloping projects through the asset-light model. With a favorable economic landscape, we have strategically positioned ourselves to capitalize on the burgeoning opportunities. At Suraj, our dedication lies in delivering world-class luxury projects that surpass expectations. With a proven history of delivering top-tier projects, we are primed for an ongoing success and expansion within the real estate sector. With this, I would like to hand over the call to our CFO, who will run you through the financial highlights. Thank you.
Thank you, Rao. Good morning, everybody. I will now run you through the financial highlights of the year ended March 2024. On the operational front in FY24, in the residential segment, we have achieved pre-sales of 1,07,136 square feet versus 1,03,044 square feet in FY23, translating to a sales value of approximately 483 crores versus rupees 437 crore in FY23, indicating year-over-year growth of 10.5% in the residential segment. Further, in FY24, there was no pre-sales in the commercial segment versus rupees 197 crore in the FY23. Collections for FY24 stood at 316 crores versus rupees 346 crores in FY23. Focus during the year was on selling luxury projects, which reflects in the improved realization of rupees 45,074 rupees per square feet in FY24 versus rupees 42,420 square feet per square feet in FY23. Talking about the financial performance, the total income for FY24 grew by 35% to 415.7 crores versus rupees 307.9 crores in FY23. EBITDA for FY24 grew by 54.3% to rupees 236.4 crores versus rupees 153.2 crores in the FY23. Operating margins stood at 56.9% versus 49.39% in FY23, which is an increase of 710 basis points over the previous year. Now, PAT for the year stood at 67.5 crores versus rupees 32.06 crores in FY24, a growth of almost 111% year-on-year. During the year, we have repaid high-cost debt to the tune of 285 crores from the IPO proceeds in the month of December 2023, and further additional 23.5 crores of unsecured loan was repaid from the gross collection proceeds. Our net debt as on March 24 stands at rupees 315 crore versus rupees 565 crore in the previous financial year, March 23. With this, I would like to open the floor for questions. Thank you.
Thank you very much. We will now begin the question and answer session. Participants present on the audio bridge who wishes to ask a question may press star and one on the touchtone telephone. If you wish to remove yourself from the question queue, you may press star and two. Ladies and gentlemen, we will wait for a moment while the question queue assembles. We have our first question from the line of Krish S. Bhatia from Anand Rathi. Please go ahead.
Hi, good morning, sir. And thanks for taking my question. Just one question from my side. What is the update on the Bandra project and when do you intend to close these?
Hi. With regards to Bandra, we've already received our concession approvals from the Municipal Commissioner for the first phase. However, since we are planning to amalgamate a few more plots, we plan to launch this later in the year FY24-25. So it'll be towards the end of the year or early next year.
Okay. Thank you. And all the best.
Thank you, sir. We have our next question from the line of Amit Agarwal from Nuvama Wealth. Please go ahead.
Hi. Thanks for taking the question. What I heard was the collections this year on a year-on-year basis were lower. So can you give reasons for that? Why were the collections lower?
So the collections are in line with the last year we had done two transactions in the commercial segment, which was 197 crores. Which this year is not there, so slightly a dip is there in regards to the collection for the commercial segment.
And is that the reason why the operating cash flows also only 9 crores as against 180 crores in 23?
So the operating cash flow was because a lot of expenditure was incurred on the project this year. So a lot of projects are at advanced stages of construction. So material amount of money went into development of the project, and also we have infused some money towards the upcoming projects like the settlement of dispute from the Malinagar plot, which we already utilized some money there. And two of our projects, Ocean Star and Palette, we got full potential approval up to 50 story and Ocean Star up to 42 story. So some amount of capital has gone into the approval costs and other construction-related costs, which are for the of our 13 projects.
Okay, sure. That's all for my side. We'll come back later. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We have our next question from the line of Anand Mundra from My Temple Capital. Please go ahead.
Hello. Good morning, sir. Thank you for the opportunity. So my first question is, so what would be our revenue and EBITDA margin guidance for this year and the pre-sales guidance as well for FY25?
With regards to the pre-sales, we're targeting a pre-sales of 850 crores for the financial year 24-25. And as to your question on the margins, I think our margins will be intact since as lands are already acquired by the group, so our margins will be intact. The upcoming projects.
Okay. And sir, anything on the revenue number?
On the sales part, we are expecting to close sales in the range of 500 to 525 crores for FY25.
Okay.
This is a sales recognized.
Correct.
Yeah.
And sir, in the pre-sales, what would be the breakup between commercial and residential?
So we are targeting pre-sales of 850 crores in FY25, of which we are expecting 200 crores from commercial segment, and balance 650 would come from the residential segment.
Okay, and the commercial segment also has similar margins as compared to the residential segment?
Yes, more or less the margins are same.
Okay. Answer out of
the residential, because the especially the commercial segment, which the land which we have bought is a vacant land where the land cost is huge as compared to the redevelopment projects. So more than the segment, it is more of the nature of project which we have acquired.
Okay. And sir, out of the current gross debt that we have, how much of the debt would be high cost debt? That would be, say, around 17-18%.
So presently, around 80 to 90 crores is high cost debt.
Out of the total gross debt?
Yes.
And at every point of time in our balance sheet, we'll have this high cost debt. Always, because we'll be executing a lot of projects. So, will this always be there on the balance sheet?
No, these high cost debt were taken for the land acquisition stage. So, which will not continue. A portion will always be there because we need money for the growth capital. So, some certain portion would be there, but otherwise we are having interest rates in the range of 10% to 12% range, which we have recently got. So over a period of time, we propose to reduce the construction funding.
Ladies and gentlemen,
hello.
Please be patient. We have the management line disconnected. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for patiently waiting. We have the management line back with us. Please go ahead. Over to you, sir.
Hi, thank you. I think the call got disconnected. We are happy to continue with the question.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, a reminder, you may press star and one to ask questions. We have our next question from the line of Ritwik Seth from One Up Financials. Please go ahead.
Yeah, hi. Good morning, sir. So, a few questions from my end. So, firstly, what kind of launches are we looking to do in FY25?
We expect to launch 7 new projects. As discussed on the call, we have a total GDV of 1,150 crores. Which will be coming out of these new launches. That is, and this will be spread across 7 projects.
Okay. So all this will be launched in FY25?
Yeah, 24-25, yes.
Okay, great. And are we looking to start our BD journey, like, you know, kickstart our BD journey in a big way? You know, what kind of BD can we expect in FY25-26? And, yeah.
So, like I said earlier, we've already actually acquired one in the recent quarter. So, that is a continuous process. But having said that, to launch what we already have. Having said that, in Bandra, there will be a few more business development proposals which we will be analyzing. So, that would be our focus, projects which are close to our current projects where you can just amalgamate and increase the potential. So, that would be the immediate goal.
Okay, got it. So, okay, and what kind of money, capital we are looking to deploy in the business development side?
If it's a society redevelopment, there's no upfront land cost, so it would be more from an asset light model. So I think that's what would be our main focus area right now.
Right. Like, can we expect to deploy 150, 200 crores on an annual basis, given our current, sale, pre-sales run rate and cash flow, or would that be meaningfully higher? I just wanted your thoughts on that, sir.
I would not want to put a particular figure in mind, but yes, it will be a continuous process. But as I said, lands, we are trying to see how we can get the best deal in lands today. And we'll continue to keep that thing. But I think close to the figure is what I could say would be a good estimation.
Okay, sure. And so you mentioned, given a detailed project-wise and value-wise breakup in the presentation, can you just help us with, the construction cost for the ongoing project, spending construction cost for the ongoing projects, and the total construction cost for the upcoming projects that you have mentioned?
Overall project cost can be in a range of 600 crores, in the entire ongoing portfolio.
Sorry, 600?
This is balance to be completed. 600.
It
includes development and other cost as well.
Right. In the ongoing projects and in the upcoming?
Upcoming, we will when guide you during the quarters where
sure.
We come up with more projects when the plans are further finalized,
Got it. No problem. Okay. And sir, just one clarification to the previous question. I think then the line got cut off. On the gross debt and high cost debt and the interest cost, what will be the interest cost in FY25 and what will be the gross debt reduction in FY25 if we can share that number?
So FY25 we expect to maintain the same debt levels. Considering the 7 project launches are there, we would require some capital for that. So there will be repayments, there will be disbursements which will be taken. So we'll try to maintain the debt level in for FY25. And the blended average cost can be considering the range of 14% odd.
Okay.
And for FY25.
For FY25. And can this be expected to come down given, our return ratios have slightly become better? So from 14% towards 10%, is there a trajectory that over the next 2 years that we are targeting, and what number would we settle at over 2-3 years?
So we target 12-13% range, 12% range in the next 1 year.
Okay.
For FY26, we can target that. This year, since we require a lot of capital for the upcoming projects, and land stage acquisition money is also taken, so we can consider 14% for this FY25.
Right. And just one last question. What kind of money we require to launch these 7 projects in FY25?
So that would be in the range of 150 odd crores.
Okay, 150 crores to launch these projects.
Yes.
Okay, sir. Okay, that's it from my side. All the best and thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. We have our next question from the line of Anant Mundra from My Temple Capital. Please go ahead.
Hello. Yeah, thank you for the opportunity again. Sir, what is our plan on the land reserves? We have about 7 land reserves. So are we planning to monetize that, or we want to develop it? And if you want to develop it, then what could be the potential sales area that we could get out of that?
So the land reserves would not be our immediate priority, because we already have about 9 lakh square feet apart from that to be launched. Having said that, the land reserves have an inherent value already. So as you can see, it's about 10,000 square meters. So we can estimate a capital of at least a lakh square feet, but that would not be coming immediately on the table. We want to first launch the 9 lakh square feet and then move into that.
And sir, what is the nature of these land reserves? Like, are they redevelopment or vacant or slum or what is it?
It is basically redevelopment. Some part would be redevelopment, some part is the slum, yeah.
Okay, okay. And sir, coming back on the high cost debt point, so is there, I mean, are there no other means of funding available to us given that we are now a listed company that we have to keep relying on this 17 to 18% high cost debt? So isn't there some other resource means available to us right now given that we are a listed company and our balance sheet is well capitalized?
The quantum of debt is going to be reduced gradually because the temporary capital we require for land acquisition, and you know, once we start the project, the cash flow kicks in, and that debt is taken for a shorter tenure. So if you see other construction finance projects, so we are getting 11-12% rate also.
Oh, so this is a very short, like this is for less than 1 year. Is that fair to assume?
Yeah. 1-1.5 year you can consider.
Okay, okay. And I missed out on the earlier participant that asked that, I mean, so whatever sale receivables that we have from the current ongoing project, are they enough to fund the construction expense that we have on the current ongoing project?
Yes, it is enough because the sales receivables are 718 crores against which we have a balance cost to complete of around 600 odd crores. But plus there is an unsold inventory which is about 631 crores.
Okay.
Which will take care of the ongoing debt which we have.
All right, all right. And the 150 crores of capital that we will need to launch the 7th project, for that we will not have to rely on any form of high cost debt. For that we will use our construction finance. Is that a correct assumption?
Majorly it will be construction finance, but some portion would be there, maybe for the commercial, Tata commercial lot, we may require some debt, which is maybe 14-15% types.
These are mainly for approval cost.
Approval related cost, which bank cannot fund. It is more of TDR and FSI related costs, like additional FSI, which cannot be funded by RBI. As per RBI circular, banks cannot fund those costs.
Okay, okay, okay. So these costs, generally when you launch a project, after launching that project, when can we avail a bank financing? After 6 months, 1 year?
Maybe 1.5 years we can avail bank finance.
So initial 1.5 years, either we do it through our internal accruals or we rely on high cost debt?
Yes, yes.
And our sole reliance on high cost debt is NBFCs.
In case of land acquisition, it can be AIFs.
AIFs, okay. Okay. All right, that's it from my end. If I have any more questions, I'll come back in the queue. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We have our next question from the line of Tushar Sarda from Athena Investments. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you for the opportunity. I was wanting to understand your interest cost because for this quarter also it is 25 crores. So annual run rate comes to around 100 crore on 400 crore kind of borrowing. So it's almost 25%. If you can just explain what is the actual interest cost.
So we recently have taken loans, increased our loans, so because of which the funds have not yet been deployed as on 31st March, which will be deployed in this particular quarter. That's why you're feeling the interest was a little high in quarter four.
No, I didn't follow. You have taken loan recently, right? So then the actual at the end of the period loan amount will be higher. Then the average cost should have been even lower. This is coming to almost 25%. Am I missing something?
So we have taken one loan from AIF at 17%, which is 60 crore we have drawn down from AIF for acquisition of the plot for Mahim. Recently we acquired the plot at Mahim, which is 1073 square meters land, which is expected to have a sales value of 120 crores, for which we have availed high-cost debt. So it's pertaining that particular project. And also,
my question is, your quarterly cost is 25 crores, right, for the Q4. as per your presentation on page 6, finance cost is 25 crore for Q4. So this comes to annualized 100 crore run rate. And your debt you have reported...
So
it's around 400 crores, right? So that comes to gross debt reported is 426 crores. So this comes to 25% interest cost.
Sir, this there are a few high-cost debts which are running as on 31st March, which will be most likely repaid in this particular financial year. So during
the
year...
No, but at what cost? High cost, you are saying 17-18%. I am getting a computation of 25%. What am I missing?
So there are processing charges, bank charges and other things also which are allied to
but
the...
But they can't be so high. I mean, if you can give the breakup of that 25 crores then. What is processing? What is actual interest cost? Because these numbers don't add up.
We'll come back to you, sir, on the numbers.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir. We have our next question from the line of Ronald Fioni from Sharekhan Limited. Please go ahead.
Yeah, good afternoon, sir, and congratulations on good numbers. On the previous question on interest cost also, I had one clarification that the interest cost had substantially come down from 47 to 25 during the quarter. So, you know, what had led to this substantial reduction despite, you know, gross debt remaining at the same level, you know, inching up.
So this is because in the loans were repaid in December 26 after our listing. So the impact of that has been coming in the fourth quarter. That's why the interest costs have reduced from the third quarter to fourth quarter, because we have repaid around 300 crore plus debt in quarter 3 FY24.
And this 200 crore commercial sale which you are expecting, that forms the part of ongoing or upcoming projects?
These are upcoming projects, sir.
Upcoming, right. So, overall, you know, if we expect 250 to 300 crore from ongoing projects, yearly sales, then you would be expecting more than 50 to 60% sales rate in the upcoming project, you know, to meet the 850 crore target. Is it true that such a high sales target you are expecting around 50 to 60% to come from upcoming projects?
So it's coming from upcoming projects, sir. 200 of commercial and I would say additional 200 from upcoming.
No, 850 is the target. So 250 would be coming from ongoing. So balance around, say, 600 odd crore would be coming from upcoming. So this is almost 50% of the 1150 crore upcoming projects. So you are expecting around 50% sales rate from the upcoming projects.
So just to clarify, out of 850 crores, 200 is coming from the commercial segment, which is upcoming project. 250 we are expecting from the residential segment, in the upcoming segment, and from the ongoing portfolio we are targeting 400 crores.
Okay, 400 from ongoing. Okay, so that means you would be exhausting the ongoing not by FY29 but much prior to that, in 2 to 3 years rather than 5 years.
Yes, there is only a few projects which are going till 29, because recently that project we have launched at Mahim, Lumina, that is only going till 29. The rest all projects we are targeting to finish in the next 2 to 2.5 years time frame.
Okay, great. And lastly, on the margin guidance which you are maintaining, so, you know, previously we had a view that it could normalize to 35 odd levels or something of that sort, but now... you are maintaining, you know, around 55 odd percentage. So what has changed actually?
Product mix has changed. Value luxury and luxury car, luxury segment has been sold very well. There the realizations are bit better than the value luxury segment. And also, the two commercial deals which we concluded last year has been come into recognition this year as well. So there also the realizations are better in those two deals. That has boosted our EBITDA margins for this particular financial year as compared to last financial year.
But that means for FY25, you would be maintaining the margins, or it would be, you know, FY26 also you can maintain the margins, or it would taper down?
Since the land's cost is already funded for, so we propose to maintain the margins.
Oh. Okay, great. So thank you very much and all that.
Thank you, sir. We have our next question from the line of Pradeep Rawat from Yogya Capital. Please go ahead.
Hi, thank you for the opportunity. I have one question. So how is the pricing environment you are seeing for the South Central Mumbai region right now?
Sorry, could you just repeat the question?
How is the pricing environment you are seeing in the region of South Central Mumbai?
So it depends on the segment we are targeting. If it's a value luxury segment, anywhere between it ranges from 38 all the way to 43 to 44,000. And if it's a luxury segment, you know, it can go from 60 all the way to around 85, 90 as well. So it depends on the location, where you are, how close you are to the sea. And generally value luxury, we see, you know, we're playing with velocity. So we make sure that we keep the price a bit constant. While luxury, we're able to kind of have better realizations.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, and best of luck.
Thank you, sir. We have our next question from the line of Rajiv Rupani, a shareholder. Please go ahead.
Yes, sir. I have a question. Now, our ongoing projects are majorly in Mahim and Dadar area, and if I see your presentation, you've given that average realization is in the range of 35,000 to 45,000 square feet. And currently in the con call, you have, from the new projects, you have said that you will get average realization of about 50 to 55,000 square feet. So on what basis are you guiding for higher realizations, that more than 20% higher realizations from new projects?
So just on a clarification, we have the average realization has gone up to 45,000. So I think there's no 35,000 mentioned anywhere. So 45,000 would be the realization which we have achieved this year compared to last year. And why we've taken a high realization is since Bandra is a very big proposal, the carpet rate in Bandra on Mount Mary Hill will be starting with a lakh of square feet. So if you look at it, a blended average, that's why we have given a reasonable guidance of 50 to 55.
Okay, and I have a follow-up question. Now, our major focus is in Mahim Dadar. So, going forward, I mean, the realization in Bandra, Santa Cruz and Khar are much higher. So, how many projects could we add going forward in the next 2-3 years in those areas?
Our focus would
Bid for some projects in Khar, Santa Cruz?
No, we haven't bid for anything on Khar Santa Cruz. We're looking at just acquisition of societies very close to what we already have so that we get a larger footprint. So that would be our prime objective right now.
Okay, and I have one more follow-up question. Now, sir, we are in the Mahim area, so that Navjeevan Society in Mahim, did we bid for that project? Could you just guide us? That's gone for redevelopment.
No, we actually didn't bid. I believe that's already gone for redevelopment with Raymond, if I'm not mistaken.
Correct. So, one more question. Now, what I know is that all the big developers like the Purvankara who were in the south and the Prestige Estates. So, can we bid for like a big project like 2-3 acres project, because there is a lot of competition. They have also entered this area, Bandra, Dadar, and also how is the competition over there?
So the land parcels which we are currently already own in Bandra is to the tune of the size which you're already discussing. So I think we already, with that objective, we are able to handle that kind of size, and that's why I said we plan to launch that later this year, early next year, because the size of the project has increased.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. We have our next question from the line of Pranav Shrimal from Pink Wealth Advisory. Please go ahead.
Hello?
Yes,
hello?
Please go ahead with the question.
Yeah, so as per your guidance, we are approximately going to have a pre-sales of 350 CR. So that would roughly translate to selling about 1.8, 1.9 lakhs square feet area. Would that be correct to assume?
Sorry, the question is not clear. Can you repeat that, please?
Yeah, so we are targeting 850 CR in pre-sales, right?
Pranav, so can you please use the handset? Your voice is very muffled.
Hello? Am I audible?
Yes, sir. Yeah, now
you're audible. So we are targeting 850 CR in pre-sales. So that would roughly translate to around 1.9 lakh square feet of area. Would that be correct to assume?
Roughly 2,60,000 for this year. The new launches, or you're saying overall 850 crores?
Overall 850 crores, we're targeting in pre-sales, correct? So
yeah.
Even if we take like a 44,000-45,000 realization rate, that would be around 1.9 lakh square feet.
Right.
So
yes.
Is that correct to assume?
Yes.
And secondly, sir, we're also raising 500 CR. If we could shed some light on that, the purpose of dilution of equity there.
Oh, that is just an enabling provision. We've not planned anything as of now, but that's just an enabling provision from the board, and which we're taking and which we will take yearly.
Okay, so nothing is planned as of now. We're just getting the approvals. Not raising in this year, is that...
Sorry to interrupt, sir. We have the disconnect. Management's line disconnected. Please be patient. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you for waiting patiently. We have the management back with us. Over to you, sir.
Sorry, I think the line got disconnected. Can we continue with the question?
Yes, sir. Just coming back, we are trying to raise around 500 CR. So is there any particular reason? Like, are we planning to expand? What are we trying to do with that fund?
So this is actually just an enabling provision. We haven't really decided to think. It's just an enabling provision of the board. As and when we get an opportunity, it's just more of an enabling provision which we will take yearly.
Okay, so as of now, is this sort of unlocking that sheet, correct?
Sorry, I couldn't hear you.
Just unlocking the provision, as of now, we fixed for using this fund.
Mr. Kram, we are unable to hear you. Can you move to a better place?
Hello?
Yes, sir. Now we can hear you. Please go ahead.
Yeah, and also, sir, recently, during the last phone call with Arjun, there was some discussion that you have taken a very high interest loan that was going to be paid off within 12 months.
Yeah, we have taken one loan, NCDs, from an AIF. That is for the Mahim land acquisition. So that is only a tenure is 5 years, but considering the cash flows, you know, we might repay them earlier and refinance with a lower cost debt in a period of 1.5 to 2 years.
Okay, got it. Thank you.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, that would be the last question for today. I now hand the conference over to Mr. Rahul Thomas for closing comments.
I take this opportunity to thank everyone for joining the call. I hope we've been able to address all your queries.
for any further information, kindly get in touch with us or Strategic Growth Advisors or Investor Relation Advisors. Thank you. Thank you, everyone.
Thank you. On behalf of Suraj Estate Developers Limited, that concludes this conference. Thank you for joining us, and you may now disconnect your line.